furnace. We came through the manufacturing tool of slavery, and we came out as human beings. We became human beings in 1975.
That's right.
We began to be resurrected in 1975. How do I know that? Read the second verse in the chapter of Jumah. Mm-hmm. It talks about one being resurrected from among you, teaching you the book and the scriptures and wisdom and sanctifying you, right?
Yes, yes.
That's the sign of the resurrection.
That's right.
Didn't God give us that leader? What did he do? He taught us the book.
That's right.
Not only did he teach us the book, he taught us the wisdom of the book.
That's right.
And he purified us.
Yes. That's right.
We are the living among the dead.
Yes.
Man, Muhammad said, you don't need the many. It's always been done by the few.
Yes.
So who are here? We only see a few? Imam Muhammad said, he teaches the message all over the country for who? His students. And what is the students doing is what you're doing.
Taking notes,
right? So the rest of them, they're heedless. They're lip professing. They say that they follow Imam W.D. Muhammad, but they were not students of Imam W.D. Muhammad.
That's right.
In the Bible, it says that Jesus, the disciples said, what should we say when you're gone? Jesus said, just open your mouth and God will speak to you. And I'll wait. Jesus' disciples, every one of them denied Jesus. Every one of them.
That's right.
And then one or two later on got an epiphany, I guess. Yes. And all of a sudden, he became almost like Jesus.
Yes.
Right? You're greater than every one of the disciples of Jesus. Every one of them. Because the companions of Prophet Muhammad, when he was being attacked and so forth, did they run?
No.
They stood. And the other Quran says, how many times have a few destroyed the men? So we are people of justice and witness of God. Can you at least give me some more patience? I don't want to run down what we witnessed here. The stone that the builders rejected should become the ace in the corner. They rejected us. But we built America. The stone that the builders rejected. These heartless people, these donuts, they had no heart. Why? Because they had no soul. So who was among them that became resurrected and came alive? A soul came alive. A heart began to pump. That's you and I. We gave America a heart. We are the heart of America. Imam W.D. Muhammad said, Barack Obama, just before he passed, he said, Barack Obama represents the heart.
That's right.
So if you're going to be a witness of justice, you have to see that we were treated worse than anything in history.
That's right.
Mm. Worse than anything in the scripture. Mm-hmm. Worse. Mm-hmm. But God, with his almighty power, he resurrected us and brought us out in human form.
That's right.
So Barack Obama represents the high. Not physically the highest, you know, that's ritualism. You have to go there, that's ritualism. But the fulfillment of the ritualism, the Hajj is a sign, but the fulfillment of it is right here. Allahu Akbar. Because if you want, Prophet Muhammad, he lived physically over in Saudi Arabia. If you want to know the closest human being to Prophet Muhammad that walked among us, that was Imam W.D. Muhammad.
That's right.
Allahu Akbar. The closest you ever see. And if, by looking at Imam W.D. Muhammad, what he did, and the great works that he did, then that is a testimony to me that Prophet Muhammad was a mighty, mighty man.
That's right.
Why? Because Imam Muhammad was a giant.
That's right.
You know, when Imam Muhammad, when he spoke in Rome, he spoke before 100,000 religious leaders.
That's right.
And then what happened? He turned around, he walked over to the Pope, and the Pope stood up.
Right.
And they were right. Iko Nuruddin, who was a Catholic in Africa, said, Pope don't stand up for nobody.
Nobody.
So you have to see yourself in that picture when Imam Muhammad is speaking to the religious. religious world, you have to see your collective soul.
Yes, sir.
David Walker, yes. Frederick Douglass, yes. You, the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, all of our collective soul was addressing the religious order of the world, and we're alive. That's you and I.
Yes.
Are we a witness?
Yes, sir.
If God is not in your heart, your heart is dead.
Yes.
And where was the crime revealed? On your heart. Yes. Amen. Muhammad gave me an example in his lecture. He said, there was an individual who he asked him, he said, do you remember something? He said, well, I forgot. Imam Muhammad said, well, if you memorized it by heart, you wouldn't forget it.
Right.
That's right.
How do you memorize the Quran? By heart, right?
That's right.
Don't you know that if your heart is solid, closed up, that God will not reveal to you?
Jeez.
It will bust your heart.
Wow.
And if it's not for the grace of God to open your breast, expand your breast, to receive the Quran, you wouldn't get it.
That's right.
And everybody's heart was closed up, except you and I.
Good.
So when you look at their Khalifa, where it talks about in the Quran about the Khalifa, if you can't see yourself as being the making of the Khalifa, you're totally lost.
Yes, sir.
You are the one that when you go out and you take the message that Imam Muhammad, the key that Imam Muhammad has given you, the lost keys that they don't have, you will unlock the whole world. You have those keys. So you are special people.
That's right.
So when you talk about acceleration, here's the main thing I have finally get to. Look again in 1975. When we were talking about the Renaissance in the past. Imam Muhammad, when he came on the scene, look at his lifetime within 30 years. He came in speaking wisdom, right?
Yes, right.
And taught for 33 years wisdom.
That's right.
You read in the scriptures, Jesus only lived about 33 years.
That's right.
And when he was in the cradle, that they asked him, he said, his mother had some questions, said, won't you ask him? He know, he spoke in the cradle.
That's right.
Imam Muhammad came out speaking in the cradle.
That's
the
right.
The cradle of civilization.
That's right.
Right here in America.
That's right.
He spoke in the cradle of civilization in the country that is the most powerful country in the whole world. The country is now that's championing the cause of human rights.
Yes.
Women's rights. Civil rights. Why? Because it was on our back. The slave, the freedom movement, it was on our back that we unlocked all the chains of slavery for the whole world. So the Renaissance, and from 1975 to now, we're in a Renaissance.
That's right.
The computer was as big as this whole world, this whole room. Now a computer is about as big as this. Or this. That's how big it is.
Jeez.
Just think about it. They started going to the moon. They started doing all those things. Then look at the country of Russia, one of the most powerful countries in the world. There was a bunch of atheists. These atheists, they had Muslims and Jews and Christians, but you didn't know about it. Why? There was inside that house praying and making sure that the shades were drawn and nobody knew because they had spies. And they saw that they were practicing any type of religion, I don't care if you were Christian, Muslim, Jew, or whatever, they would have killed you or put you in Siberia.
Yes.
But then when that atheist country fell, all of a sudden, all the religions flowered in Russia.
That's right.
Just like you and I. They took God out of our minds. We might have saw God being a white man. We might have saw all that. We might have had God out of place. But eventually God put him back in his place.
Back in his place.
That's right.
And that's what Imam W.D. Muhammad did.
That's right.
God has been moved out of place in the world. Everywhere. Prophet Muhammad. You hear more about Prophet Muhammad now than you ever did.
That's right.
Look, Imam Muhammad in 1975, he started Juma. That was a sign of our resurrection.
That's right.
When we started Juma, everybody's doing Juma.
That's right.